it is the college of Krishna Dipta. So already in previous class we have discussed the important topics like crops, vegetables and orchids. Today we have discussed the importance of land ownership, houses, animal rearing, basket weaving. So here we have discussed the real life of the people today. Right, what is the real life of the people in Pedamakuru village? Land ownership. Those who are the people have a lot of land in Pedamakuru village. Particularly, Pedamakuru village have 700 families, 750 families. Total, the village of this Pedamakuru is 750 families. In the 750 families, 10 families have above the 10 acres. 10 acres are above the 10 acres of land. These people are called landlords. Just a few people only have a lot of land in Pedamakuru village. Remaining 150 families. 150 families have 5 acres of land. These are the middle family people in Pedamakuru village. Remaining people have no land. They have no land, and some people they take the land from the landlords to lease. And some of the people, remaining people, are the land laborers. Agricultural laborers in Pedamakuru village. This is the life of the people in Pedamakuru village. There are 700 families. About these 700 families, 10 families have 10 acres of or 10 acres of land. 150 families have 5 acres of land. Remaining families have to take the land from the lease for the landlords. Remaining people, they work for these lands. They are called laborers, agricultural laborers. That is the life of people in Pedamakuru village. Next, houses. Different caste of people have the different types of persons in the village of Pedamakuru. Different caste people, not only one or single caste or double caste. They have different caste people have live and different professions have people from the Pedamakuru village. And most of the land inhabited by the people of landlords. People of landlords means the main land is in the hands of landlords only. Other people, they are nearby the canal of Bandar, and some of the people they live from the south region of Pedamakuru village. South region of Pedamakuru village. And middle of the village, here we are discussing from top and south. Middle of the village, those are the people to live from the middle of the village means the people like those are living from the middle of the village. They have such type of professions, their main occupations. What are the main occupations means they have a self-occupation. What is the self-occupation means? Some people they are established the kirana shops. You know children, the kirana shops. RMP doctors. They are not the MBBS doctors. They are RMP doctors. And medical shops. Iron and welding shops. Hair salon. And tiffin centers. These are the other occupations. The people, they are well settled in middle of the village. Most of the people, those who are living from the Pedamakuru village, they are well constructed their houses because of the people, they are well settled in Pedamakuru village. Because throughout the year, the people, they are having such type of agricultural jobs. That's why people, they can construct such type of houses in Pedamakuru village. Next, animal rearing. Most of the land is being cultivated by the people. Most of the land in Pedamakuru, they are cultivated. There is no space. The people, they are rearing the animals. But whatever it, the people, they are rear very few animals like bullocks, cows, buffaloes and sheep. Why these animals only the people they choose to rear the animals from the Pedamakuru village means these animals, the farmers, they are used their own agricultural works. That purpose, the people, they are used these type of animals for the Pedamakuru village. The next one, like basket weaving. Most of the people, they are migrated to Pedamakuru village. Why the people, they are migrated to Pedamakuru village means yes, such type of work is also available for the Pedamakuru village. So that's why number of people, they migrated to Pedamakuru village. 50 to 20 families, they are migrated to Pedamakuru village to work. Most of these people, they are well settled nearby the Bandar Canal. They have no permanent houses. They they are constructed such type of small huts. Yeah, these people's main work is to making the baskets, catching the rats, and rearing the pigs. These are the main occupations of the people of these migrated families from Penamakuru. Yeah, one of the best example from these chapter, those who are the people to migrated from Penamakuru place means Jagannath Nancharaya. He was also one of the person to migrated from other area to Penamakuru village. He was well settled near to the Bandar Canal. His main aim is to collect the date palm stems near the Bandar Canal and making the baskets. So he had 30 years old Jagannath Nancharaya and his wife, they made the baskets every day, five or six. These baskets they sell nearby the villages. Yeah, another example like Kanta Sivaya. He was also one of the migrated person. So he was also well settled near the Bandar Canal. His main aim is to catch the fishes in Bandar Canal. Bandar Canal. Whatever he catches the fishes are he sell in nearby the villages of Penamakuru. Villages of Penamakuru. That is today's topic, children. That's all enough. Tomorrow class we'll discuss it here. Before I complete this class, I have one small assignment. Get ready? Write the first question. How many families in Penamakuru? Second question. What are the things the people use to make the baskets? These two are the today's assignment. Thank you, children. You have to complete the assignment and read the textbook properly. Thank you.